Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.4 Beta 3 to developers and hopefully very soon to public beta testers. Usually it's out by the time this video is released. Now, this particular update came in at 754.4 megabytes, that's on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it was similarly sized on all the devices in this video, the iPhone 11, iPhone 6S Plus, iPhone 10, and iPad Pro. Apple also released iPadOS 15.4 Beta 3, WatchOS 8.5 Beta 3, tvOS 15.4 Beta 3, HomePodOS 15.4 Beta 3, and macOS 12.3 Beta 3. All of those are available now if you're a developer and hopefully soon to public beta testers. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About, and you can see the build number is 19E5225G. And this particular update does include some changes and updates as well, and the first thing is a modem update. We went from 1.57.00 to 1.59.00 on the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Many others had this update as well, so if you are having connectivity issues, again switching between different cellular versions, it should be a little bit improved. Of course, it will take a few days to know that for sure. Now, the first thing they've updated has to do with software update. Now, this is technically part of Beta 2, but when people went to update to Beta 3, many people, despite not being on 5G, were able to update over LTE. I had some people send in a screenshot, so let me show you that. And as you can see here, this is a screenshot from a phone that's on LTE that actually is downloading the update. So they were able to do this now, and others were showing that they're actually getting a notification that says use cellular data to download, and then you can tap continue. I've actually seen that before on 5G, but never on LTE or 4G. So going from beta 2 to beta 3, many are seeing this where they're able to install it just using cellular data, even if they don't have 5G. And many people will be happy about this if you don't have easy access to Wi-Fi. So hopefully we'll see this not only with this beta, but future updates as well. Now there's a small change in Face ID. So if we go into our settings, we'll go back here and then we'll go down to Face ID and passcode. Put in our password. If we scroll down, and if you're on a phone that's iPhone 12 or newer that allows you to use Face ID with a mask, you'll see that we have the option for require attention for Face ID. This has been there for some time, but now if you turn it off, you have a dialog that pops up that says requiring attention makes Face ID more secure. If you turn this off, Face ID will unlock your iPhone even if your eyes are not clearly open and looking at the screen. Face ID will always require attention when you're wearing a mask. So if you have this feature, you'll need it turned on in order to actually use this with a mask. So just something that's a little bit new that they've added in this update. If you're using Apple's Podcasts app, the first time you go in, you'll get a new splash screen mentioning some new features. Now, this feature does not seem to be active since the podcast creator will need to set it up. But if we go to our photos, I have a screenshot here where it says what's new in Apple Podcasts. Filter episodes, and when viewing a show in your library, filter episodes by played, unplayed, downloaded, or saved, and browse by season. Browse by season appears to be a new feature or change where it says go to any show and filter for a specific season. Many shows have different seasons, and so this looks like it's going to be a nice change for those of you that post podcasts with seasons, such as the Serial podcast that has a few different seasons, but I wasn't able to actually find it and it's not showing. So hopefully they'll add that in the future as people use podcast more and more. However, I typically use a different podcast app myself. After installing Beta 3, some people are seeing under settings at the top that it says review emergency SOS. I haven't seen this on any device I updated here, but according to 9to5Mac, some users are seeing it. So at the top here, you'll see it says review emergency SOS. So that's something I actually haven't seen at all, but apparently some users are actually seeing it. One thing that seems to be new and updated is if you have an iPad Air with Touch ID on the top, there's some new settings, under accessibility for the top button. So if you tap on top button, you'll see that it says click speed, default, slow, slowest, adjust the speed required to double tap or triple click the top button, press and hold to speak, Siri off, and then also rest finger to open. So there's some changes here as well that have been updated, some of the wording as well. Within Beta 3, Apple has mentioned that they've resolved one issue according to their notes. They've fixed an error within the Health app when attempting to add an EU digital health certificate from France, Ireland, or Singapore. That's now fixed in those countries. With Beta 2, they resolved it in other countries, and by the time this is fully released, it should be working properly everywhere. Now, one thing that I believe is resolved, but they didn't mention specifically, and that's the storage bug. I've had multiple people message me saying that it's resolved. However, it does seem to take a while to load for some people. On my 13 Pro Max, when trying this initially, it took a very long time to load storage. So it does seem to work. And if I scroll all the way to the bottom, it seems like everything is loaded, whether that be on the iPhone 10 or 13 Pro Max, system data and everything is actually loaded this time around. So it looks like it's resolved, but again, that will take some time to know as there's many different phones and many different configurations out there. So I'd love to hear from you in the comments below if it's resolved for you. Beta 3 also contains 13 known issues. That's actually down from 15 with Beta 2. And there's a few notable ones, some that are still from Beta 2, still occurring in Beta 3, such as signing into the iPad is limited to apps in this beta. The health app can crash when you attempt to onboard the blood oxygen feature from within the app, and pairing of thread accessories in the home app still seems to be causing a problem. However, the new one that they've mentioned that is on iOS and macOS, it's possible to trigger taking a photo of a participant when in a group FaceTime call. It says on iOS, this could occur when you tap the grid button or the bottom left corner of the screen. On macOS, this could occur when you click the grid button or top right corner of the window. So rebooting the device may resolve that issue, but that's something that's known. But they haven't mentioned that they've resolved anything else, but there is still that pink screen bug. Now, this may be resolved for you, but on newer phones, it could sort of go to a pink or purple display and then reboot the phone. They haven't mentioned whether they've fixed this. And I've also seen people mention online that the music bug does not seem to be resolved yet. So if you were having that music bug when streaming music, some people were experiencing significant battery drain, and that was due to the CPU using more power. So it was using a lot more power streaming. It does seem that that's still going on. So definitely something that they need to fix still. Now, as far as iOS 15.4 Beta 3, and if you should install this update, well, this particular update does seem to be better as far as bug fixes, as most of them will be, and Beta 2 was quite stable. So if you wanted to try it out, you can, but just be aware that you still could have issues. This is a beta, and you need to report those in the feedback app if you are having those issues. As far as when to expect iOS 15.4 Beta 4 and the release candidate and final release, well, now that we're on a weekly cycle, I would expect it next Tuesday or Wednesday where we see Beta 4, with a release candidate the following week in the first week of March, and then a final release sometime around the new Apple event we expect in March around March 8th. So typically around that time frame, we should see a final release with a new Mac event, it looks like, with some new iPads and that iPhone SE 3. So all of those things are expected around that time. Now, as far as overall battery life in this update, well, it will take a few days to know, and I will have a follow-up on the weekend like I normally do. But if we go to our settings, go to battery health on my 13 Pro Max is still at 100%. I charge it every night like all of my iPhones, and it seems to be doing well. But Beta 2 was not that great. So 2 hours and 53 minutes of screen on time, 10 hours and 17 minutes of screen off time, and I used about 50% of my battery. So far today, I've already got better screen on time and 6 hours and 29 minutes of screen off time, but still something is using background activity, such as music, even though I'm not even using it. So there's definitely some issues going on here, but again, it will take a few days to know for sure. As far as overall performance, everything does seem to be performing well, and some people have said that using Minecraft is not the best example, but it does seem to be okay. The beta was quite slow upon initial boot up on this phone, and you'll see here, if I load Minecraft, I'm curious what you would like to see other than this, maybe a speed test of something else that would help you better determine what the overall performance is like. But again, speed seems fine. The stability and smoothness of everything seems to be fine, and frame rates look good. But as far as other apps, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below what would work for you best as far as showing you what it's like. Also, the overall heat of the device seems to be okay. Upon the initial installation of Beta 3, the back of the phone was not that hot. Some people are concerned about that, and I really wouldn't be too concerned as Apple does regulate the temperature with the processor and everything else, but it seemed to be nice and cool on all these phones, which was not the case before. As far as the overall benchmarks, I did run that on a couple devices here. I just wanted to share that. So I'll share that on my 13 Pro Max, and you'll see that the single core, we'll go back here, we'll go to history, as some, for some reason it sort of didn't show it, but you'll see here, 1,730 for single core, 4,602 for multi-core. That's upon running it initially. If we take a look at the previous ones, it's definitely a little bit lower as far as multi-core. Probably if I ran it again, it would be fine, but single core is better this time around. It's still within the region that it should perform about the same. ProMotion and everything else seems to be fine as well. Now, I'll run the benchmarks in the follow-up video so that we can have a better idea of all the devices, but typically sharing that in this video doesn't really show what it's like after it's run for a few days, so I wanted to share it in those videos instead. So that's it for iOS 15.4 Beta 3. Now, if I find more things within this update, of course, I'll share it in a separate video as far as more new features. And of course, there'll be a weekend follow-up just like there is every week where I talk about battery life, stability, additional bugs, and how it's been overall for all of you. So be sure to check back for that community poll as well. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.